Everyone, I'm Adrienne Everhart, your feminine energy dating and relationship coach. In this video, I'm going to talk about why it is such a great idea to rev up your feminine energy by dating an unattractive guy. Don't miss this video. You're going to want to hear why it is such a good idea to date a guy who's not really your type, and I'm going to tell you all about leading him on and all these other concerns you might have. Don't worry, stick around. I can't wait to share this one with you. And I'm so glad you've stuck around to the end because I wanted to share my own experience about my husband and I and how when I met him, he wasn't what I envisioned I would be marrying or spending the rest of my life with. I have a really popular program called New Man Manifesto, a 12-week course, and it comes with homework, and it uses manifesting and law of attraction tools to actually help you attract the high quality man that you desire and you want in your life. Now, one of the things I get you to do in that program is date what I call the non-applicable man. Now, some people say non-applicable, I say non-applicable man, and this may be a guy, the NA guy. He may be a guy you're not really attracted to, but you don't find repulsive. So you like things about him, like he might drive a really good car, have a good job, be very smart, really love his mom, yet his smile just sends a weird vibe down you, or his eyes are too far apart or too close together, whatever it may be that makes us individually find someone attractive. Now, I might get some negative comments about, you know, we shouldn't be leading a man on, and we shouldn't be really pointing out that someone is ugly or unattractive or something like that. But the truth is, we all have our own preferences to what we find attractive and unattractive. We all have something that triggers us, whether it's symmetry or some quality or familiarity that we find attractive or not. So by dating a man that you don't find just drop dead gorgeous, he's got something about him that you're not quite sure about, you're actually gonna feel more comfortable. You're gonna feel more comfortable to practice your tools on him. Now remember, there's dating and there is a relationship. When you are just dating, no one owes anybody anything. You're just dating, you're just seeing where this goes. No matter how many dates you go on, you don't want to date someone for like a year and a half, of course, but to go on a handful of dates, there's nothing wrong with that. There's nothing wrong with dating someone and just seeing if feelings unfold, just seeing where things happen. While you're dating the non-applicable man or the guy you're not attracted to, you get to practice your tools. You get to practice your feeling statements. You get to practice leaning back. You get to practice all the feminine energy techniques I teach you about how to widen and breathe in through the hips and below the waist of your body, and how to receive from a man. Now, a lot of times when we meet a guy and he's so super hot and we're so into him and he's just driving us so crazy, we actually are so nervous that we can't really practice our tools. But with the non-applicable man or a man that you're not too attracted to, you can actually slow down. You don't have to worry about it, and you can practice your tools with him. Now, when you practice your tools with a man, what happens to your feminine energy is that it gets greater and greater and greater around you. You get stronger in feminine energy. No man out there is going to say, yeah, I don't want to date a beautiful woman for 4 or 5 dates. They want to spend time with a beautiful woman no matter what. So don't worry about leading a guy on or going on one date and instantly knowing I'm not attracted to him. I don't want this type of guy in my life. You know, so often we say no because we're looking for this instant attraction. And that instant attraction maybe worked in your 20s, but when you get older, it's really about who treats your heart the best. You're really wanting to find a man who treats you well, a man who treats you with loving kindness and consistently, a man who can provide and maintain and isn't so threatened by your power or whatever it may be about you that he has to compete with you or that you compete with him. This is what a masculine energy man is all about. So while you're dating your non-applicable man or the man you're not that attracted to, you're gonna start practicing your tools and you're gonna start feeling really good and confident in those tools. And you're also gonna learn how good it feels to receive. When's the last time you had a guy really blowing up your phone wanting to date you and see you and take you places and spend time with you and get to know you? This is especially important if you're rebounding from heartbreak or divorce. You want to feel cherished and admired, and you want to feel that masculine energy coming towards you. It will really, really help your feminine energy. You're also going to help that man's masculine energy. You may date him just 4 or 5 times and maybe never see him again. If nothing unfolds for your heart, you may just really not feel anything for him, attractive or unattractive, whatever it may be. So when you allow him this time with you to cultivate a relationship, you're having lots of many trials on dating. Both of you are getting practice, so don't feel like you're leading a man on. There are no promises, and you owe no one anything when you are just dating them. I cannot stress this enough. Masculine energy mindset in a woman leads her to believe, I have to only date a man I find instantly attractive and instantly know I want to be with. That is masculine energy. That's how masculine energy works. When a man meets you, he will either feel something for you or not, and you cannot force anything in between. When a man decides he wants to marry a woman, it is that woman, and there is no second thought or guessing about it. You see how confident and sure that is with just one option? That's how masculine energy works. Feminine energy, we are okay experimenting. We're okay trying a couple of different things on. Not to have a sexual conquest, which is a lot of times what masculine energy does. They try a lot of different women on because it feels good and they're having a great time. Well, a woman can do the same thing in her feminine energy. There's nothing wrong with trying out lots of guys, dating them, and seeing where it goes and how you unfold as a person. I'm not saying sleep with all of these men. I think you should still follow a dating protocol and have boundaries that work for you. But by getting to know the non-applicable man, you're practicing your tools, you're learning how to receive, and you're also helping this man. So don't feel like you're leading him on and you're doing something wrong by dating him and hanging out with him. Know your boundaries. And know that if after the 4th or 5th date, you don't feel like totally making out with him and getting really close to him or ripping his clothes off, it's just probably not there. Now, the last thing that might happen with a non-applicable man is you might really fall in love with him. You might fall in love with how he treats you. And I'm so glad you've stuck around to the end because I wanted to share my own experience about my husband and I and how when I met him, he wasn't what I envisioned I would be marrying or spending the rest of my life with. I had a particular type I was really drawn to, and he was not that type. I had always been attracted to men that were darker, darker hair, darker skin, more olive tones, whatever it may be. That was just naturally what I was more attracted to. So my husband is very fair skinned. He has blondish brown hair and he has green eyes. And he's tall and he's well built and he has a great frame. But for some reason, when I met him, all I could focus on was this tooth in his mouth, this one tooth that was different. And I had seen it in some of his photos. And I knew that I wanted a man who just had a perfect, healthy smile. Well, as I got to know him and he kept coming over and he kept taking me out for Thai food and he kept fixing things in my house and he was taking good care of me and my pets. He would take us to the park and spend time with me and my little dogs. I was falling in love with this man because I was falling in love with how wonderful he treats me. But that tooth, it was still just kind of irking me. So I finally decided to ask him about it. And come to find out, it's actually a baby tooth that never grew into an adult tooth. And so many things came together in that moment, just how cute it was that he still had a baby tooth. I actually still have baby teeth that just never had adult, you know, teeth come in. And so we ended up kind of having this really funny conversation, and all I did was nosedive deeper into love with him. So sometimes it's the little things, something that's perceived as a flaw, that end up being really precious to us. And we actually end up building a wonderful, loving relationship that feels so tight and close and warm based on the things that were otherwise or previously considered flaws. So that is why I believe you should date a man that you're not just right off the bat attracted to, or has all the qualities or qualifications that you're seeking in a partner physically. Go for what is in his heart. Practice your tools. See how it feels to receive. See how it feels to be pursued by a man. And most importantly, pay attention to how a man treats your heart. All right, ladies, I hope this video has been helpful. Check out my program, New Man Manifesto, if you want to learn more. It's a great program and it's full of 12 audios, bonus audios, a VIP library, and worksheets that will help you get to manifesting the type and quality of man you want to have in your life. All right, everybody, thanks so much for tuning in. I'm sending you much love. I can't wait to hear from you in the comments section. And please like or subscribe to my video. Bye.